Next witness.
Your Honor, please, while waiting for the next witness, may we be allowed to make a short manifestation with clarification? Thank you, Your Honor. Thank you for allowing us to make the short manifestation, Your Honor, with clarificatory question on the issue of the quashal of the subpoena on Secretary De Lima. Naghain po kami ng motion na i-quash o ang subpoena kay Secretary De Lima dahil sa paniwala po namin na delay ang resulta nito. Ayon po mismo sa request for subpoena ng defense, ang lahat ng pwede nilang or gusto nilang itanong kay Secretary De Lima, ayon mismo sa request nila, ay natanong na po. And in fact, they were given all opportunities to ask these questions during the two days po na nag-cross-examine sila kay Secretary De Lima. Ngayon po, hindi naman namin iniisip na ang depensa ay may iba pang itatanong at mislead ang impeachment court sa tunay na purpose ng pagpatawag nila kay Secretary De Lima. We do not suspect that. Ngayon po, ang sabi namin, ang korte may discretion na i-deny siyempre ang motion or request for subpoena kung tingin ng korte irrelevant yung testimony, immaterial, o pampahaba lang ng kaso. In fact, may mga subpoena na na-deny ang korte. Katulad nun, may Supreme Court na driver na pumunta dito, willing naman mag-testify. Pero again, grant ng korte ang request ng Supreme Court na hindi sila isubpoena. At may poder ang korte whether or not to grant or to deny the request. Ganun din po sa clerk of court. Willing naman ang clerk of court. In fact, the clerk of court has appeared here previously. Pero ang problema noon, nabulatlat yung salen. So nung na-request ang subpoena niya ng Article 7 team, hindi na po siya napayagang mag-testify dahil sa sabi ng Korte Suprema, bawal mag-testify sa korteng ito ang mga personnel ng Korte Suprema. Ngayon po, ang tanong po namin ay, nakita po namin kasi itong sulat ni Secretary De Lima. At nagsasabi po siya dito na she is, of course, opposing the motion, the subpoena, the request for subpoena of the defense. Pero po may sinabi po siya dito.
What is the date of that letter?
This is May 7 po, 2012.
Today
po. Sinabi niya po dito, this is, however, without prejudice to the undersigned's continuing sentiment regarding the propriety of her recall to the witness stand, as well as her appeal for her rights to such witness under Section 3. This is for the impeachment court to decide whether or not they will continue with the grant of the subpoena or withdraw it. It's for the court to decide. The court has mentioned in so many times that it wishes to avoid collision with other co-equal branches. However, I'd like to go to the other part of the letter, Your Honor. In line with this, the undersigned respectfully requests clarification on the intended scope of the defense panel's examination of the undersigned and also whether they intend to treat the undersigned as an unwilling or hostile witness. So ngayon po, ang tanong lang po namin, may nabanggit na po ba ang defense panel kung ano po ang scope ng kanilang examination? Kasi ang sabi po namin sa prosecution at sabi rin ni Secretary De Lima, lahat po na yan at testify ko na yan eh. Ano pa ba ang pwede kong sabihin dito, baka dalawang araw na hindi ko pa nasabi or wala silang oportunidad na matanong nung panahong nag-testify po siya. In fact, hindi mo rin po pwedeng i-claim Chief Justice Corona that he is deprived of due process rights. Hindi po. Ang Korte Suprema po, in fact, nung winithold ang mga witnesses from the Supreme Court, wala talaga kaming opportunity to ask them kasi hindi talaga sila pumunta dito. Kami po sa prosecution, napresenta si Secretary De Lima, wala po kami intensyong itago, walang tinatago si Secretary De Lima. In fact, nag-appear na siya. Ang hiningi lang po ni Secretary De Lima at ng prosecution, ano pa po ba ang gagawin at pang-delay na lang ito ang pag-testify niya? Kasi ayon po sa request, these are the same issues discussed. So ang hiningi na lang po namin, baka may gusto pang itanong ang depensa, ang depensa, na hindi nila naitanong o hindi sila pinayagan ng korteng itanong noon na gusto nilang itanong kay Secretary De Lima ayon po sa tanong ni Secretary De Lima. I'd like to ask for a clarification on that, Your Honor, if they've answered the question of one, the intended scope of the defense panel's examination of Secretary De Lima, And also, whether they intend to treat the undersigned.
Are you asking for a reconsideration of the ruling of this court?
Well, Your Honor, under
no, I'm asking you.
Yes, Your Honor, if there is a senator who is willing to move for a reconsideration, of course, we would be very happy because that's natural. That is our motion. And secondly, Your Honor...
Well, then you ask first if there's a senator who asked for a reconsideration because I cannot allow a waste of time in discussing this. The chair has already ruled.
Actually, Your Honor...
The proper procedure is... And I understand where you are coming from.
Thank you, Pa.
To ask somebody to make a motion for reconsideration.
Actually po, nasa judgment ng senator, ang hiningi ko lang po, may tanong po, nalinaw na po ba ng depensa?
All right, if the defense wants to explain why they want the Secretary of Justice to come back and be their witness, please say so.
If Your Honor, please, Joel Bodigon for the defense.
Yes, please.
By way of reply, I believe the rules define the proper time for us to make, to manifest to this court the purpose of the testimony that we would elicit from the witness. Not at this time. We are wasting the time of this court by manifestations like this.
All right.
Your Honor, if I may. Actually, kung sa manifestation lang lugi kami sa defense, araw-araw, marami silang manifestation. But anyway, Your Honor, ang tingin namin po, yung request for subpoena, hindi ka po pwedeng mag-mislead dyan. Kasi nung nag-desisyon ang impeachment court at ang Senate President for that matter, syempre tiningnan niya po kung may relevance.
I assure you, Mr. Counsel, for the prosecution, that this court cannot be misled.
Yes, Your Honor.
We are as intelligent as you are.
That's what I also presume, Your Honor. But they are now saying that they have certain purposes.
It is not a presumption. We are elected by the Filipino people because they think we are intelligent enough to protect their interests.
Yes, Your Honor. I'm my point being, however, Your Honor, is that meron pala silang mga purpose na hindi nila sinabi dito sa atin. And I'm sure that when the court decided to grant the request, tiningnan nila ang validity, ang relevance, ang materiality ng request. Ngayon po, kung hindi po pala yun ang intention nila at may iba pala silang purpose, sana naman na-apprise yung impeachment court para maka-decide ng impeachment court kung relevant pa nga ba ang testimony o hindi.
Do you know
po
their intention?
Ang intention po nila nakalagay sa request nila. Ang tanong ko lang po, yun pa ba ang intention nila?
Sinagot ka na eh.
Ang sagot po nila, may intention po silang iba.
The pero request of the gentleman is denied.
Well, thank you, Your Honor.
Thank
but
you,
we
Your
hope
Honor.
That the clarification later on for the purposes, we will reserve our objection, of course, to any new purpose that they will state during the offer of testimony of Secretary De Lima. Thank you, Your Honor.
Counsel for the defense, call your next witness.
Yes, Your Honor.
Good afternoon, Senate President. Attorney Lee Chauco, we're calling our next witness, Ms. Aniline Moises, who is the records keeper of records officer of the City of Manila. But just to abbreviate the proceedings, Your Honors, if you can make a stipulation, because she's really just being presented to... Well, she's being presented for the purpose of authenticating certain documents as far as the Basa-Gidotti transactions.
What are those documents?
Yes, Your Honor, maybe they can just enumerate, then we can react thereafter.
What are those documents to be authenticated?
Ordinance number 7975. Which was pre-marked as Exhibit 227, the deed of sale between the Basa-Gidotti Enterprise, Inc. and City of Manila.
I think that is not in issue anymore, a factual issue.
Yes, I mean...
Is there any dispute about this?
I don't think so, Your Honor. I don't even think if our good witness here can do any better than that of the good mayor. Because what she may have to testify to today must have been taken up already lengthily by our good mayor. But most especially pertaining to the documents being adverted to.
Your Honor, the previous witness, the counsel for the prosecution was questioning that some documents were Xerox copies. Now we are presenting certified true copies, so it won't be questioned.